A plane can travel 1,600 miles in the same time it takes a car to go 310 miles. If the car travels 258 miles per hour slower than the plane, find the speed of the plane. This problem deals with the equation distance equals rate times time. So let's go ahead and record all the information we know about the distance, rate, and time for the plane and the car. Well, we know the plane flies 1,600 miles, that's the distance, in the same time as it takes a car to go 310 miles. So the car travels 310 miles. Notice how it does say in the same amount of time, but we don't know what that time is. So let's go ahead and put a t here for time, but we can use the same variable t for the car because we know these two t's are equal to each other. Next it says if the car travels 258 miles per hour slower than the plane, we want to find the speed of the plane. So we don't know the rate of the plane, so let's use r for the rate of the plane, but we do know the car is traveling 258 miles per hour slower than the plane, so we can express the rate of the car as r minus 258 miles per hour. So from here, let's write our two equations. This first equation here would be 1,600 equals r times t, or rt. And the second equation would be 310 equals the quantity r minus 258 times t. Notice how we have two equations with two unknowns, but remember we do know that these two t's are equal to each other. So now we're going to take these two equations and solve them for t. So if we have 1,600 equals r times t, we divide both sides by r. We know that t is equal to 1,600 divided by r. If we take the second equation, 310 equals r minus 258 times t, and divide both sides by r minus 258. This simplifies to 1, and we have t equals 310 divided by r minus 258. And since these two times are equal to each other, these two ratios must also equal each other, which will give us an equation with one unknown. We want to solve the equation 1,600 divided by r equals 310 divided by r minus 258. If we solve this equation for r, we'll then be able to determine the speed or rate of the plane. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. This is a proportion, so a quick way to clear the fractions would be to cross multiply 1,600 times the quantity r minus 258 must equal r times 310. So again, we'll have 1,600 times the quantity r minus 258 equals r times 310, or just 310r. Now we'll go ahead and clear the parentheses and solve for r. So we'll distribute here. We'll have 1,600r minus 1,600 times 258 is equal to 412,800. Equals 310r. We need to have r on one side of the equation. Let's just say we prefer to have r on the left side, so we'll subtract 310r on both sides. At the same time, let's go ahead and add 412,800 to both sides of the equation. So here we'll have 1,290r, this will be 0, equals 412,800, divide both sides by 1,290. We have r equals 320. So if we go back to our question, if r is equal to 320, that means the plane is traveling 320 miles per hour. And it doesn't ask, but the car would be traveling 320 minus 258 miles per hour, which would be 62 miles per hour. Okay, I hope this explanation helps.